Okay, so, recording. This is my Fanto installation, and I did step by step what I did in my VirtualBox videos in this kind of tutorial, and these steps seem to fail on the end in VirtualBox. You got to use the Calculate Linux IDE or a live disk to install Fanto actually, and I think it's the same for Gentoo, because there are some commands, if you use MX17, it just does not work. So just stick with the Calculate ISO file, it will do a really good job. And I mean, you might just like Calculate Linux and install it instead, because Fanto is fun, but you have lots of compiling. So of course, if you have a second computer, then it's okay to have something like that. But if you just have one system, you might get stuck having it compiling. I showed in the VirtualBox videos what Calculate Linux is capable of doing, compiling, running everything on 100%, recording, and I could still open VirtualBox and compile something in real life, and you couldn't even see it on the movement on the Windows or on the recording or anything. It was just amazing. What I do, I have a partition which I call home, which is never used as a home partition for any distro, but I put my documents on it, music files, videos, apps, all my configuration files for Thunderbird or Basilisk or Waterfox and Clawmail and stuff like that. And that's the SDC7 in this case here. So I made an invisible file in my home directory .home and mounted it over there. And that's how I did it. Yeah, so I just /dev/ the SDC, then I called it /home/dirk.home. And that is this one here. I just opened it up. I will close this here quick. Go away. And I moved already over my Basilisk, my Clawmail. You see that this link symbol here. Moonchild Production is a Basilisk folder, Thunderbird, Waterfox. So here I will put it away because it's just confusing. So, and I deleted here documents, music, videos, and stuff like that. So, what I do now, I just go over homelog.home. I put the apps over already, so desktop public. So now I have to move my download folder. Download folder, ISO files, doink. Share with me, that will be my Synology disk station stuff that will be coming over here. And then video, doink. Then I need my virtual boxes, right? Because we want to see if we can get VirtualBox easy running here. And I think we will. So, this was it. Now I've got all my files here. Now I'll go back here. And in my Synology drive, there are my documents, because I haven't had a document file here. So, I move that over here. And then I've got something what I call Linux tweaks that goes here. And now Linux tweaks for me, usually I have I'll put it here, so I've got all the stuff that would need, I need catfish and stuff. So it looks really basic what I have here in a moment, and it really is. You see, I want to emerge VLC because I have no video player. If you install Fanto, you really have nothing available here. The settings you have with XFCE, you get Thuna, XFBurn, Sandbox, new PDF, and Ristretto Image Viewer, Multimedia, I installed OBS, I have XFBurn here. System, I put into HTOP here, bulk rename, manage printing, Thuna, file, and XFCE terminal, and that was it. You got nothing. Even mousepad. I have to install mousepad. I've got nothing here. I've got no editor. I've got so I'm doing this now, but as you can see, I'm recording and I'm running here almost on 100%. So I will give it not too much stress that I start emerging here while I'm recording. So I will give it a test, but not with VLC right now. I'll do a step-by-step guide how I got here. I will do again a VirtualBox install where I hopefully get it to work, and I think if I change to MBR, MS-DOS partition table, it should work. I could not understand after I corrected the boot partition in VirtualBox that it just doesn't work. So it's a miracle to me that the installation in VirtualBox did not work. It worked fine on real hardware. Step by step like that, on real hardware you will have no trouble. It just works fine. How to get the how XFCE running and stuff like that, it's easier than it looks like. So it's easier than it looks like. And what I really need, I will search for this quick. I want to, you see, I'm an XFCE guy, and but I really need also or let's say Whisker. I need the Whisker menu. So I have to search for Whisker. I really need it, Whisker menu. That's the only thing what is missing in, and here it is already. What is missing in XFCE that they don't put it in right away by themselves. So what I can do now is I can go here. I got this. And copy or paste my XFCE plugin in. So now it's asking for the password and I will send this up. And I stop that video here now. This is my Phantom video. Simple Screen Recorder did not compile properly. It broke off with an error, so that's why I couldn't make the video yesterday after midnight. So I run OBS. OBS installed fine, works fine. I can't see the videos because I have no video player, but I know I have video and I have sound, and I hope this video, the sound quality is okay. Yeah, then this is it, guys. Stay tuned, there's more coming. Sorry for the hiccup with the VirtualBox Fantoo, but I can tell you if you follow the steps which I used in VirtualBox, they will work just fine on real hardware because I did nothing different. I did exactly what I did years ago, what I did just a few days ago on the VirtualBox videos, and they work perfectly here. And once I've got you parted, I can show you again that I have a GPT partition here. Because what do I have? I don't think you can see it like this. No, it doesn't tell you GPT partition now. But that's how it looks like. You see, I've got CylinderOS here, I've got Calculate Linux on MX17 swap partition, my invisible home partition. And yeah, some other stuff. So I have to install a few things in order to make it work, and I will have breakfast while this is compiling. You know what? I got to get Gparted too, so let's find Gparted. That's how I do it in a moment because I haven't installed EIX, I think it's called. So I look for Gparted. Because that's for me an important tool too, that is what I need to have. Gparted. Let's have a look. I want to read it. That's a good thing usually, you know, these steps you could do overnight. So that you don't have to worry about the thing, right? Dev Python, Gparted. Oh no, parted, PyParted, Gparted. That's the one I want. I guess. Okay, so I add this here too. I'll put my Gparted on. Don't want the password yet. And what I want else is mousepad. So let's see if mousepad is here. There's mousepad, so we can use that too. And then I will run it here. No, that's not what I wanted. Look what it did to me here. So, I will fire this up in a moment when I cut this video off, and I will upload this video, and I hope you like it. Because I could not understand that VirtualBox installation failed. I couldn't find the mistake after I changed the boot partition, the BIOS boot partition from GPT. If it is a glitch in virtual box. I have no idea. But I do know what I showed works on real hardware, and that counts to me. And yeah, I will investigate. But not only, because then this channel is purely fun to, over fun to. It will have fun to, of course, because I have to make the same this system look a little bit better. Then I have to use it to give my conclusion about it, how I like it. And of course, I will compare to Calculate Linux. And because that's my daily driver. And if there's nothing better coming, I would not change. And yeah, I don't think there's anything better. Oh, challenge again. I mean, I know Das Gregor is not watching in a moment. He seems to be busy. Irish too. Who knows? Or maybe they're on the run. They got caught for... I mean, Irish could have been caught for putting systemd on Gentoo. You know, that people are now after him. That's possible. That's a crime, you know, putting this on. So, and Das Gregor, I don't know, he's a tycoon, he's a mystery man, we don't know really what else he's doing but and up to, but there is something cooking. So, nevertheless, I will install now all this stuff while I have a nice cup of coffee, and I think I watched now Das Gregor's video and the crime recorded from Irish, where he put systemd on Gentoo. I mean, the whole Gentoo community must be upset. Okay, so this is a video. I'm still tired. I just woke up. I'm happy to see that my system didn't froze. It hibernated here and everything was doing okay. So no trouble. Having said this, on this computer, Calculate Linux freezes when it switches the screen off. So that's interesting to see that there is a difference. What the difference is, I have a higher kernel here. Maybe the kernel makes a difference. I don't know if I froze the kernel here too on Linux. I have to have a look. So, but this is it, guys. I have to fire this up, and I don't want to have it interfering with my recording. You see, I'm on the edge here, so it takes more power here. But that's okay. I hope you liked that video. Sorry for the yawning. One day I'll become more professional. Yeah, I will be more professional. But no, I will not monetize this channel ever. I pass all my theory exams for my driving instructor, so now I just have to do the praxis, hope pass them all too. In the summer I'll finish my commercial pilot license. I don't want to write the commercial written exam ever again. That was torture, guys. That was a long written exam and long learning for it, and very difficult. So I just want to do the flight exam, get it done, have my commercial pilot license in the pocket, and good is. Until then, next video is coming up later, where I show something. Maybe I try to do the step by steps, but I have to make kind of a script to not confuse people. So, and yes, you can use the VirtualBox install. Just use it, if you use GPT, use the BIOS boot partition. That it's a 10 megabyte unformatted partition, which you have to leave open. And then this is it. And I haven't mounted boot when I installed it, because I didn't want to, and it worked just fine. And if you have a look, I didn't mount it boot. I have a boot folder, and it's served properly from the Funto system. This all shows up. Yeah. There will be more information in the next video, because there is... Oh, yeah, people don't watch this to the end, I guess. I have more than one install and more than one hard drive. That means I have more than one grub bootloader running. And Funto installed itself on a bootloader on this hard drive very nicely without any trouble. While my Calculate Linux and all the others do not find the boot option for Funto Linux. They call it something like base, Funto base, blah, blah, blah. I will write this down and then I show this. And I do not know why they don't find Funto. It's not a big deal in my case. I have a boot menu, it just looks normal. It works normal. I've got two kernels on, which is nice. You know, you have the latest kernel and an older kernel, which could be the LTS kernel, so to keep it safe. I use a Debian kernel here. I don't build my own. It's like reinventing the wheel, you know. If something is done already okay, so why do it again? I haven't installed firmware here yet. I will do that too, but I just wanted to cut it short here. If I would have installed firmware, this might still be compiling forever here. So that cost my nerves. Yeah, I must say, when you want to have something done and your computer's compiling, that's the moment you say, yeah, you know. So you have to have a second computer where you can work with, that you don't have trouble if you have something like that. Or you have to decide everything you do it in the evening before you go to bed. You switch it on, and next morning it's compiled. Or in case like Simple Screen Recorder, it's not compiled. It compiled, but it didn't finish. So then you have nothing. However, that was just Simple Screen Recorder for now, and I know there were trouble before for people. Maybe it's again. So I will fire this up. Video is over now, guys. I hope to see you soon, and I hope you like that video. I did exactly what I did in VirtualBox, except that I did with the GPT partition, I had my system boot partition here, my BIOS boot partition, and that's it. I didn't mount boot, I just mounted the root folder, the main folder, the SDA3, or here it was SDC4, and that was it. That's the install you see in the information video about Fantoo. And all I had to do was reboot and build Xorg and then XFCE, and this is it. But I tell you guys how I did it. There were some little tiny editing files I had, or files I had to edit, which are important to make your experience smooth. Because I didn't even try if X worked. I just did XFCE, I fired it up, all works. But I go there step by step. Okay, guys, sorry for the hiccup with VirtualBox, but I don't know. I do believe it's a VirtualBox thing. But I'll try it again. We'll never give up. Okay, guys, hope to see you soon, and I hope you like that video. None of my videos gets many likes anymore. I just get 3 likes for 30 views. This is very little. I got to get to professional. No, guys, this is just me in the basement. Maybe one day I get more professional. But and usually this should have worked, the VirtualBox install, because it worked on real hardware. And that's the annoying part, you know. It looks like I'm unprofessional. I'm unprofessional. But the installation should have worked anyway, professional or not. The step-by-step guide was okay, except that I went GPT and I didn't mention the GPT BIOS boot partition you have to have. But I have an extra video on that too. Okay, guys, but I make another video in a VirtualBox one day, not too far away. But I just want to finish here the Fantoo installation, because I will do it on Fantoo, the VirtualBox installation with Fantoo, and then we go from there. All right, because I have to test Fantoo. If I don't test it, how can I tell you how good or bad it is? I have to put my printer on my scanner. I've got some office work doing things like that. I need to work, make it work, right? Okay, guys, if somebody watched here to the end, let me know why up images don't fire up as standard. What do I need to do if they're marked as executable, that up image do not fire up here in Fantoo Linux in the brand new fresh install? I might just miss something that they don't fire up. But if you know, if somebody watched to the end, that's actually a good thing to see if somebody watched it to the end. I could only imagine Sergi, Nix, I forgot, guys. I can't say that name. We need proper speakable names, I must say. And he hasn't commented for some time. Nix, so I would have to search for a long time to find him. So, oh, even maybe Rogonugi knows that. How do I get up images running here? Because that would be nice to know. Okay, but this is it, guys. Now I have to cut it off, and I have to have my breakfast so that my voice comes back and I relax. Okay, I'm happy to see Fantoo working and running as I expected it to do on the VirtualBox. I love you all, guys, and I hope you stay with me and stay tuned and help me out to make Fantoo fun to work with. Okay, this is it, guys. Have a good day and speak to you in the afternoon.